bad actors or something. Mary, that's Mary's rage.
Today, it's a busy day of shooting, but I noticed that Mary had like a bunch of extras, did a makeup test and a hair test on all these extras because she wanted to make sure that the look was very, very specific, and it was really specific to that time period. That's pretty unusual, particularly on a small film like this. Usually you would delegate that kind of thing. You'd kind of give the marching orders to, you know, the department heads and kind of check photos with them and all that sort of thing, and then you'd go on. But in this case, that's been a huge part of the work, finding those details that make that period specific.
Finlandia. Detective Kent Campbell.
Hey, Campbell. Call me Don.
Don.
So, you hang out here a lot?
Yeah. I mean, whenever necessary, you know? How's the investigation going? Taking anyone in for formal questioning?
Oh, no. Informal conversations, mostly. What's that, Finlandia?
No, they're out as usual. Fucking dump.
Too true. You see, Bateman, formal questioning is okay, but people tend to reveal so much more about themselves in relaxing settings, don't you think? They just can't help themselves. They want to confess. I mean, they want to get caught. Another cocktail?
Dan, great to see you again. Like I said, you need anything at all, I'm your man. I don't envy your job. I mean, Paul Allen was a complex man. Hey, Rasta man! I mean, man! We be jamming?
You know, in every decade and generation, and there's always a period of time where the wealthier are treated with more respect. It's usually the case. But the 80s, for some reason, it was coming to people younger. It was being given to people who were probably, you know, less deserving, as it usually is, you know. There was just something particular. You know, it was also the first time we were, you know, I mean, I guess with Nixon, but with Reagan, we were being, you know, unlied to untold amounts, you know. I mean, the whole Iran-Contra thing, which is touched on in the film. I mean, it was just like, and I mean, talk about a scandal. I mean, it was a little hard to follow, you know, a little harder to follow than you know, someone, you know, getting, you know, filleted in a hallway. You know, that's pretty clear cut. But you know, setting up secret governments and, you know, secret, you know, military agencies is pretty fucking heavy, you know, and to have that kind of I don't know, and I think we're getting wise to it, you know, and I think we're getting smart and more cynical to it. And ironically, as opposed to becoming more caring about our society, we're becoming less caring and more, it was becoming more permissible, you know, so.
I'm leaving. I'm getting out.
Leaving what?
This. Don't. I'll drink it. Listen, Patrick. Listen to me. I'm leaving.
Where to? You gonna go get a gram?
I'm leaving. I am leaving.
Don't tell me. Merchant banking?
No. You dumb son of a bitch. I'm disappearing.
Where to? Morgan Stanley rehab? What?
Hey, Bryce, don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry. Be happy.
Goodbye, fuckheads!
What? Come back!
The greed and the selfishness of the 80s sort of contributes to the comedy in the film and how ridiculously superficial everyone is and self-consumed and that, you know, makes for wonderful comics, you know, sense and a great sort of story. But I think ultimately, I mean, this film had to be in the 80s just because I don't think male-female relationships have ever been exactly as they were in that time. And it was a very different time, you know. AIDS was, you know, just sort of coming to the forefront you know, was sort of in the front of everyone's mind. And women had sort of a different attitude about sex and sexuality that is very different than any other time in American culture.
Why don't you just go for Bryce?
God, Patrick, Bryce? Why Bryce?
He's rich.
Everybody's rich.
He's good looking.
Everybody's good looking, Patrick.
Got a great body.
Everybody has a great body now. What do you want me to do with that? Floss with it? Are you using minoxidil?
No, I'm not. Why should I?
Your hairline looks like it's receding.
It's not.
Looks like it.
When I read the script, I was really compelled by it and fascinated with the way that they'd captured the period and what they were saying about that period in time. I wasn't offended by it in the way that I've since learned many people were, particularly women. I guess when the book first was published, National Organization for Women came out against the book. And it's very disturbing. There's no question that it's incredibly violent, especially the book, towards women. But really, I think it's the men that come off looking ridiculous. The women, yes, there are things that are done to them that no one would like to think about. But it's the men who all call each other by the wrong name and never acknowledge it. It's the men who are particularly obsessed with the exterior appearances and ultimately come off as just not there.
Lewis is a despicable twit.
No.
I hate him.
You idiot. I said it's a receptacle tip. Not is Lewis a despicable twit. Is it a receptacle tip? Get off me.
Is it a what?
Pull out.
What do you want, Courtney? It's a plain end, I think.
Turn the light on.
Jesus. I'm going home.
Patrick, turn on the light.
It's a plain end, see? So?
Take it off.
Why?
Because you have to leave half an inch at the tip to catch the force of the ejaculate!
I'm getting out of here. Where's your lithium?
Do you think you're turning me on by having unsafe sex?
Jesus Christ. This really isn't worth it. And see, Courtney? It's there for what, huh? Tell us, why is it pulled down half an inch? So it can catch the force of the ejaculate.
Well, it's not a turn on for me. I have a promotion coming to me. I don't want to get AIDS.
See? Happy? You dumb bitch. You happy? You dumb bitch.
God, just get it over with.
I really found a lot of humor in the book, as sick as it was, and I thought it was an interesting comment on society. I thought it was it rang true. I found a lot of truth in the book, and I think that the film brings out a lot of the humor even more. It's very funny.
Pick up this Vassar chick at Tunnel. Hot number, big tits. And so I take her back to my place.
Whoa, wait, may I ask where Pamela is during all this?
Fuck you, I want a blowjob, Bateman. I want some chick who's gonna...
I don't
want
to hear this, he's gonna say something disgusting.
You prude. Listen, we're not gonna invest in a co-op together. We're not gonna jet down to St. Bart's. I just want some chick whose face I can sit on for 30, 40 minutes, right? Anyway, so we're back in my place, and this chick's had enough champagne by now to get a fucking rhino tipsy. And get this.
She let you fuck her without a condom?
This is a Vassar girl. She's not from Queens. She would only, are you ready? She would only give me a hand job. And get this, she kept her glove on.
Your date a Vassar girl.